In the name of Allah, the All-Beneficent, the All-Merciful. Ha, Mim, Ain, Sin, Qaf. Thus does He reveal to you and to those who were before you, Allah, the Almighty, the All-Wise. To Him belongs whatever is in the heavens and whatever is in the earth, and He is the All-Exalted, the All-Supreme. The heavens are about to be rent apart from above them, while the angels celebrate the praise of their Lord and plead for forgiveness for those on the earth. Look, Allah is indeed the All-Forgiving, the All-Merciful. As for those who have taken guardians besides Him, Allah is watchful over them, and it is not your duty to watch over them. Thus have we revealed to you an Arabic Quran, that you may warn the people of the mother of the towns and those around it, and warn them of the day of gathering, in which there is no doubt, whereupon a part of mankind will be in paradise, and a part will be in the blaze. Had Allah wished, He would have surely made them one community, but He admits whomever He wishes into His mercy, and the wrongdoers do not have any guardian or helper. Have they taken guardians besides Him? Say, it is Allah who is the guardian, and He revives the dead, and He has power over all things. Whatever thing you may differ about, its judgment is with Allah. That is Allah, my Lord, in Him I have put my trust, and to Him I turn penitently. The originator of the heavens and the earth, He made for you mates from your own selves, and mates of the cattle, by which means He multiplies you. Nothing is like Him, and He is the all-hearing, the all-seeing. To Him belong the keys of the heavens and the earth. He expands the provision for whomever He wishes, and tightens it for whomever He wishes. Indeed, He has knowledge of all things. He has prescribed for you the religion, which He had enjoined upon Noah, and which we have also revealed to you, and which we had enjoined upon Abraham, Moses, and Jesus, declaring, maintain the religion, and do not be divided in it. Hard on the polytheists is that to which you summon them. Allah chooses for it whomever He wishes, and He guides to it whomever returns penitently. They did not divide into sects, except after their knowledge had come to them, out of envy among themselves. And were it not for a prior decree of your Lord, granting them reprieve until a specified time, decision would have been made between them. Indeed, those who were made heirs to the book after them are surely in grave doubt concerning it. So summon to this unity of religion, and be steadfast, just as you have been commanded, and do not follow their desires, and say, I believe in whatever book Allah has sent down. I have been commanded to do justice among you. Allah is our Lord and your Lord. Our deeds belong to us, and your deeds belong to you. There is no argument between us and you. Allah will bring us together, and toward Him is the destination. Those who argue concerning Allah after His call has been answered, their argument stands refuted with their Lord, and upon them shall be His wrath, and there is a severe punishment for them. It is Allah who has sent down the book with the truth, and He has sent down the balance. What do you know? Maybe the hour is near. Those who do not believe in it ask you to hasten it, but those who have faith are apprehensive of it, and know that it is true. Look, indeed, those who are in doubt about the hour are surely in extreme error. Allah is all attentive to His servants. He provides for whomever He wishes, and He is the All-Strong, the Almighty. Whoever desires the tillage of the hereafter, we will enhance for him his tillage. And whoever desires the tillage of the world, we will give it to him, but he will have no share in the hereafter. Do they have partners besides Allah, who have ordained for them a religion which has not been permitted by Allah? Had it not been for the conclusive word, decision would have been made between them. For the wrongdoers there is indeed a painful punishment. You will see the wrongdoers apprehensive because of what they have earned, while it is about to befall them. But those who have faith and do righteous deeds will be in the gardens of paradise. They will have whatever they wish near their Lord. That is the greatest grace. That is the good news Allah gives to His servants who have faith and do righteous deeds. Say, I do not ask you any reward for it, except love of my relatives. Whoever performs a good deed, we shall enhance for him its goodness. Indeed, Allah is all-forgiving, all-appreciative. Do they say, He has fabricated a lie against Allah? If so, should Allah wish, He would set a seal on your heart, and Allah will efface the falsehood and confirm the truth with His words. Indeed, He knows well what is in the breasts. It is he who accepts the repentance of his servants and excuses their misdeeds and knows what you do. And he answers those who have faith and do righteous deeds and enhances them out of his grace. But as for the faithless, there is a severe punishment for them. Were Allah to expand the provision for his servants, they would surely create havoc on the earth. But he sends down in a precise measure whatever he wishes. Indeed, he is all aware, all seeing about his servants. It is he who sends down the rain after they have been despondent and unfolds his mercy. And he is the guardian, the all-laudable. Among his signs is the creation of the heavens and the earth and whatever creatures he has scattered in them. And he is able to gather them whenever he wishes. Whatever affliction that may visit you is because of what your hands have earned, and he excuses many an offense. You cannot thwart Allah on the earth, and you do not have besides Allah any guardian or helper. Among his signs are the ships that run on the sea, appearing like landmarks. If he wishes, he stills the wind, whereat they remain standstill on its surface. There are indeed signs in that for every patient and grateful servant. Or he wrecks them because of what they have earned, and he excuses many an offense. Let those who dispute our signs know that there is no escape for them. Whatever ye have been given are the wares of the life of this world. But what is with Allah is better and more lasting for those who have faith and who put their trust in their Lord. Those who avoid major sins and indecencies and forgive when angered. Those who answer their Lord maintain the prayer, and their affairs are by counsel among themselves, and they spend out of what we have provided them with. Those who, when visited by aggression, come to each other's aid. The requital of evil is an evil like it. So whoever excuses and conciliates, his reward lies with Allah. Indeed, he does not like the wrongdoers. As for those who retaliate after being wronged, there is no blame upon them. The blame lies only upon those who wrong the people and commit aggression in the land unduly. For such, there is a painful punishment. As for him who endures patiently and forgives, that is indeed the steadiest of courses. Whomever Allah leads astray has no guardian apart from him. You will see the wrongdoers when they cite the punishment, saying, "Is there any way for a retreat?" You will see them being exposed to it, humbled by abasement, looking askance secretly, and the faithful will say, "Indeed, the losers are those who have ruined themselves and the families on the day of resurrection. Look, the wrongdoers are indeed in lasting punishment. They have no guardians to help them besides Allah. Whomever Allah leads astray has no way out. Answer your Lord before there comes a day for which there is no revoking from Allah. On that day you will have no refuge, neither will you have any chance for denial. But if they disregard your warnings, we have not sent you as a keeper over them. Your duty is only to communicate. Indeed, when we let man taste our mercy, he exults in it. But should an ill visit them because of what their hands have sent ahead, then man is indeed very ungrateful. To Allah belongs the kingdom of the heavens and the earth. He creates whatever he wishes. He gives female to whomever he wishes. Or he combines them males and females and makes darrow whomever he wishes. Indeed, he is all-knowing, all-powerful. It is not possible for any human that Allah should speak to him except through revelation, or from behind a curtain, or send a messenger who reveals by his permission whatever he wishes. Indeed, he is all-exalted, all-wise. Thus have we revealed to you the spirit of our dispensation. You did not know what the book is, nor what is faith, but we made it a light, that we may guide by its means whomever we wish of our servants. And indeed you guide to a straight path, the path of Allah, to whom belongs whatever is in the heavens and whatever is in the earth. Look, to Allah do all matters return.